What is up, guys? It's your boy Wes Borders. So yesterday I asked you a lot whether I should do a tutorial on a moody self-portrait or an extreme close-up on the eyes, and most of you said eye. We need the eye because the eye was a banger. So before we move on, let me show you the picture. Here's the picture. Here is what we are expecting from today's tutorial. Judging by the title, it is a how to take macro photos without owning a macro lens. So in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to do that with any lens, but there's a few little restrictions when I experimented out. For this photo that I took, I actually used a pretty simple setup. Number one was my 5D Mark IV, because you need a camera with good low light capabilities, or you can counter that with good lighting. And also, surprisingly, the shot was taken with a 50mm 1.4. Okay? A 51.4. This lens by no means is a macro lens. By no means it's a macro lens. But the trick here is very, very simple. All you have to do is just take the lens, detach it, and put the front element right like this. And now you actually have a macro lens. So what happens is, when you have a lens in the opposite direction, the image magnifies, and the image that is laid on the sensor of your camera is magnified image, and the focal length, the focal range where the focus clicks in, is actually very short. So that's why you can have very close things and it still would focus. See, right now my camera is actually like trying to focus on my finger, but it's not within the minimum focal distance of having that focus. Understand? Now the one drawback, there are several drawbacks. The one drawbacks, the light that comes into your sensor is cut out by a ton. Like, even though if you have a 1.4 lens, the light that comes in through the camera is very little. I might be over exaggerating by saying very little, but it's not what you expect from a 1.4 lens to be amazing in low light. The second drawback, you cannot focus on far distant objects. So like right now, I'm sitting right now to you and you can see me, right? If I reverse this lens right now, not only will the image be magnified, but you won't be able to focus from a distance like where I am at. You really, really, really need to be very close into the subject when you have your lens reversed in that way. Now the second drawback, when I tested out on wide angles like this one right now, it's a wide angle, I saw that it doesn't work properly. Like it doesn't focus anywhere. Maybe I did something wrong, but I found out that it is barely usable when you have an ultra wide lens flipped onto the opposite side, you trying to do this macro photography thing. So what I prefer is having a large aperture lens, something like this 85 beast. Look at that aperture, bro. Like, oh my. And also a 51.4. now the shot surprisingly was not taking at 1.4. now what I found when I was doing this photo shoot, when you have it on f1.4, like when you have it on 1.4, which is the widest it can go, when you have it onto the opposite side detached and you have it on the opposite side, the shallow depth of field is too shallow, like really goddamn shallow, that nothing, or like maybe a line, you can clearly see a line that is just in focus, everything else is out of focus. So when I first shot the eye with f1.4, very little of the eye was in focus, and the 1mm away from the eye was out of focus, which is you don't want that. You need a crisp photo, right? So what I did was I stopped the lens to f5.6. Now that's why I'm saying you need a good low light capabilities in your camera, because the ISO when I shot was 3200 ISO, and you don't want a lot of grain when you shoot a crisp photo. You need a banger, right? You don't want some grain in the banger. Now on to the next part of this video, and that is the technique of how I shot the eye. Now, lighting is key, and if you have good lighting, you don't need good lighting. That's the catch, you don't need good lighting. I used this very cheap piece of shit that doesn't even light my face properly from this far. So all you need is a flashlight, because we use the flashlight, and I'll tell you the reason why. Now, when we shoot an eye, we need some directed light. You don't want diffused light. You need a bit of directed light, and I'll tell you why. When you have a harsh light like a flashlight, one, it's directed to the eye, and number two is that you have more control to where you're gonna point that light. Now, when I was testing the shoot, the first thing I did was I actually took this and just straight into my eyes. Now I'm blinded. Not only will this blind your model's eye or whoever's eye you're trying to shoot, it doesn't create depth into the eye. There's no depth. There is no feeling of there's another planet inside your eyes. And really, if you want to see a character or soul of a person, look into their eyes. Eyes never tell lies. And yeah. So if you feel like someone is lying, just look straight into their eyes and you'll understand. Okay? Now, where did I place my light to get better depth? Now I found out, since the first layer of our eye is transparent, okay? It's transparent. The lens of an eye is transparent, and that's where you see the pupil, the dark circle. Now, when you shine light towards the side, light gets trapped inside your eyes. I mean, it's not trapped, it just illuminates your eye from the side, and your eye kind of glows. That's how you light the thing. Light it from the side, not directly. If you want depth, light it from the side. And there you have it. Follow these steps and you will have a banger of an eye shot like this one. Like, easy, like seriously easy bangers. But yeah guys, hopefully you guys have enjoyed and learned something throughout this video. You're lucky it's not something where I go on Lightroom or Photoshop, but the next video will be something like that, since you want also the Moody self-portrait that I took, which is this one right now. I'm gonna do a tutorial on this one. Don't worry, stay notified. See you on the next one. And yeah, like, subscribe, comment, whatever, and peace out.